Hello, so this method is pretty easy to do and fun, and you only need to do it for 2 hours. You'll get about 10,000 scrap minimum per hour, but also a lot of other resources. So you just have to reroll the map on the easiest difficulty until you get Forgotten Prison. Then you'll have to find the Ascension Spire, speak with the guy in there, you'll get 5 grenades. Do the Hatchery or the other one, the Putrid Realm, which is the Transit Dungeon, and over here you'll have a lot of things to do, depending on the map layout and how much you want to farm. So, first of all, the extraction hub or the Titan's Reach ship, you can just do it. It's a very, very fast location that will be usually in the middle of the map or very easy to spot. The extraction hubs give a lot of materials, plus you can get a navigator helm which you need to open the Titan's Reach crashed ship. And there you can also level up your plasma gun, you'll get some resources, but this is the better one. And after that you just have to search the map for the engineer armor set, which is pretty easy to find. Usually you'll find it where you see spikes in the distance. And then depending on what other dungeons you have, you might also want to do them. For the example, the Dormant and Rudian facility is great because you can finish it in about 3 or 4 minutes. And you'll also get a Corrupt Illuminite boss at the end. Which means you'll also get some Corrupt Illuminite, which is amazing because you will get a lot of resources. So yeah, and you also might do some other things around the dungeon or on the overworld. It depends on how much you know the game, and you'll really love Neruda. I love it because it's one of the easier maps to do because it's just an open area. You cannot get lost. You just search the corners and you'll find it. Same for the other dungeons. So, what items will you be getting while doing this? Well, you'll be getting 5 grenades every run because it's pretty easy to find that guy, the custodian, and speak to him. I don't know. Talata needs grenades to be killed. So, that will be 625 scrap in the beginning. And if you kill Talata, that's 1000 scrap. Plus the scrap you'll be getting from defeating the boss itself, so that's a lot more money, believe me. Also, it depends on what you find in the world as well, because like I said, if you find a dungeon insert or something that will give you the Corrupt Illuminite Crystal, that will be amazing. Also, you can sell the Simulacrum if you want, but it's not so... Yeah, I don't know, depends on you. I don't like to sell it personally. And you can also find the Ionic Crystals and a lot of other cool things as well. As you can see, the map is filled with stuff you can sell, and just depends on how much you know the game, so... This might come to personal preference, but also personal knowledge of the game. So by doing the first dungeon, you will get about 1000 scrap. But okay, let's do some of the activities. First of all, we'll do Extraction Hub, because it's one of the more obscure ones. I think you get Extraction Hub about 1 out of 5 or 6 attempts. The other ones will be Titan's Reach, but like I said, it's good. You can get scrap as well, but also upgrade your plasma cutter, which was one of the favorite weapons in Remnant 1. I'll also detail all of the map at the end of the video, and also, like I said, it's one of the more fun ways to do it, and you can also do it with a friend, so you can search for the engineer set and you can do some other things. Oh, not this one. Yes, this one. Doing it alone might be a little weird. Also, use the engineer. Put your turret over here. There will be a lot of enemies over here coming for you. So make sure to wait for all of them. Don't worry, you will kill them fast. You also get, of course, the gun, which will allow you to use the swarm. And the one that will have the helmet should be around here somewhere. I don't see him. He's usually hiding around the corner or somewhere. Where is he? I mean, you'll see when you'll instantly recognize him because I think he's supposed to wear the helmet, but he's not wearing it. Oh, yeah, there he is. You can see he has... it's a bug. So that's 200 scrap. plus the scrap already got. And then you can also go on the other side to get another trinket. Sadly I got a bit lost. But don't worry, you'll get the hang of it. It's just that you don't have this dungeon a lot of times. So that's the exit, and you also have a big chest over there. Let me see. Don't go there because that's the exit. I guess you shouldn't forget your turret here. Calm down, game, calm down. The sound is pretty amusing as well. I don't know, I think I like it a lot more because it warns me of danger. Oh, okay, over here. So follow the water. That was, what, 200? Let's say 500. And this is 500 as well. Again, this is one of the more rare ones, so probably you'll get items rich a lot more. But when you get this one as well, it's so cool to just get all of this free loot. Oh yeah, it's much easier now that I remember. So you also get the big chest. The big chest can have a lot of cool things in it. Let me see. Galvanized iron, forged iron. 100 scrap. Anyway, that's actually a sizable reward in my opinion. So this dungeon alone can give you 1000 scrap. It's actually more if you sell some of the resources or if you really need the iron, like I said. So this is more of a general farming area. Titan's Reach will not give you as much, but you can level up your Plasma Cutter, which is a gun you can really, really use and enjoy. Plus one level, and it will also give you some scrap. So, now let's go to the second location, which is the Engineer set. I'm curious what it gives you if you pick up the Engineer item again. So, let's see together. Okay, there we are. You can also dodge roll straight into it if you want. Oh, it says bag is full? Weird. Okay, I guess that works as well. So now we can just explore the map. And as you can see, usually we'll have something over here that will either be the a little staircase with some other rewards, but the simulacrum will usually be over here no matter what. As you can see, it's on the hill. If not, it will be under construction or something. And it can also have the ionic crystal over there, plus the simulacrum, plus other things as well. So make sure to check out the outdoor location. Vault of the Foremost, like I said, it can also be completed. Now, where is that big door? We're back. Well, that's weird. What is this supposed to be? Game is so buggy. And again, this is up to personal preference. If you farm a lot more, if you do some of the dungeons, it will definitely get a lot better. Plus, the map has so many dungeons that can be completed in 4 minutes or under 4 minutes. Especially if you know what you're doing. But like I said, it's only the dungeons that don't have elevators. And you can also fight the corrupted boss, it's pretty easy. Okay, this will not be very hard because the boss itself is not very hard, and if you do this a lot of times you should be able to out damage the boss very easy. You can choose whatever secondary you like. Gunslinger is the best. You can also use one of the grenades on him for fun. I guess we'll use one of the grenades on him for fun, so let's see how that affects him.
So you have found them. The Ember sees all.
Yeah, you also have to find the Soul Spark Cylinder. Which is not so bad because, like I said, you'll be searching for the corners of the map for the encounter anyway.
Our fate is inevitable. All that remains is yourself. Only because I want for the Drazi. Yet I did not force. That is your.
No.
So.
This is the easier option, by the way. I throw grenades at him, he throws the coffins at me. Why so cruel, man? His weak spot is the mouth, by the way. Pretty easy. So what? You get 2,000 scrap or something crazy like that.
Oh, that's right. You scrap with the wrong guy.
Oh, so you don't get that all the time, you only get it once. Okay, so I guess the first time you... That's a miscalculation, so I guess you only get that once, but to kill this boss you get a lot of scrap anyway, so I guess it's more or less okay. Okay, so we're back. I'm not sure what happened, but looks like Cass has the enlarged heart for sale on my world. Why? I have no idea what this happened. I just killed the old boss and it appeared over here randomly. It was not here before because I checked the store. Weird. Yeah, I guess that's how you get the enlarged heart. Anyway, the point was that you make, let's say, 1,000 scrap for the first dungeon, plus a lot of other materials, because you have to do the dungeon itself. You get 625 from the grenades. You get, what? How much did I get for Tal Rafa? That was 2,000 scrap or more. No, yeah, at least 2 more. So let's just say 4,000, plus if you do a dungeon, plus if you do Titan's Ridge or the Extraction Hub, plus if you do the... If you get the engineer armor, that's actually going to be a lot more than 6,000. It might be close to 10,000 per run if you do everything, including one or two more dungeons, if they are very, very fast to do and you know what to do, how to do them.
Your debt's still at 2 now. Remember that. Well, hey.
Shut up. So yeah, let's also sell all of the grenades because I'm definitely not going to use them. So you can just farm the boss and the grenades and maybe the of course you have to still do the first dungeon. So you might even be able to get 4,000 per 15 minutes. I don't know, it's crazy how much this can scale up. Depends on your luck as well. Like I said, you can find the simulacrum or you can find also the ionic crystal. You can also find a lot of materials. If you do the Dormant facility or some of the other very, very short dungeons on Nerud, you can also get the corrupted Luminite crystals. Plus all of the materials that just lying on the wall, like the forged iron and the iron, and the skill books, because Nerut is very, very open area, so you can get a lot of materials. I don't know. Depends on everyone how they want to optimize their build and also their way of doing it. But definitely worth it, definitely worth trying for a few hours, and you'll never need to do anything else, because look at how much crap I have now from basically doing this once, plus what I had before. More happy that I got the enlarged heart. I don't know how, I guess it's just randomized. By the way, this is not even on the Fextra Life wiki page. Maybe after you kill a wall boss or something. Anyway, bye bye.